Dear friends, welcome back to the video. The last two sessions I covered some basic concept and what is difference between Spring Framework and Spring Boot, how the legacy non-Spring based project differ from Spring Framework. So many concepts we have seen. From now on, we're going to see, going to cover mostly the practical sessions. Okay. In this video, we're going to cover how to create a simple Spring Boot web application or Spring Boot REST application, Spring Boot REST application. Okay, in order to create a Spring Boot application, we don't have to put much effort. In the go to Google and find Spring Initializer. Once you find that, you will get this link. Open that link. In that link, select a Maven project. Maven project nothing but it's a build management tool. That is, if you want to create any project, if you want to compile or build any project, we need some tool, right? There is a two popular tool. One is Maven, another one is a Gradle. In this project, I'm going to show the I'll use the Maven build management tool to build and execute our project. Okay, so that I selected the Maven project. We are using Java. Then Spring version is 2.3.0. Then project metadata. That is what is the package, what is the project name, some description. These things we need to enter in this form. My project name is group name is com.itgarden. Then first app. Artifact is a first app. Name is a first app. Artifact name is a both are same. So that I am given first app. Description. This is my first Spring Boot application. Then package com.itgarden. I'll give you something called I keep it as it is now. Then I will decide what package we need to create. The base package is com.itgarden. Group name also com.itgarden. The upcoming session I will tell what is a group name, what is the package name. Okay, everything you're going to get automatically get understand. Okay, but I will explain what is a group name, what is a package name. Okay. Then whenever I build this particular project, I want to bundle it using jar file. I'm going to use a Java 8 version. Okay, this is the basic thing we need to fill. Then we need to add a dependency. In the last video session, I told, right, if you want to create a web application, we need to select appropriate jar file. In the case of Spring Framework, you should know what are all the jar file we need to include. But in the case of Spring Boot, you don't have to do that. If you want to create a web application or RESTful application, you need to add a one starter project. We need to add a one starter project. That starter project we can select through add dependency. If you say web, Spring Web. Spring Web is one of the starter project. Build a web including RESTful application using Spring MVC. If you select a web as a starter project, web as a dependency, using this web starter project, you can build a RESTful web RESTful application as well as a web application. Okay, I selected here. Once selected, all you want to do is generate. In the generate, I will go into Spring Boot 3. I save in here. Go to save. Okay. Now I want to open an IntelliJ IDE. I'll going to show this demo through IntelliJ IDE. There are many softwares available. The many editors, Java editors available to work with. I prefer IntelliJ. Okay, once you open your IntelliJ, you need to import that project. Okay, I have created that project in Java training, Java tutorial, Spring Boot 3. In this location, I have saved that particular Spring Boot project, which is generated using the website, right? I want to import this project in my IDE. All you want to do is file, new, project from existing source. Project from existing source. Sorry, before that you have to do one thing. You need to extract that file. Extract here. No, this is the first tab. Spring Boot project created. There are some default classes get created. I will going to explain later about that. Okay. I have mentioned the com.it garden. Under that IT garden, there is a one application, one Java file created that is called as first app.application. Okay. Now I want to import this particular project in the IntelliJ. File, new project from existing source. Suresh under Suresh Java training, then Java tutorial, Spring Boot 3. In first web app, first app folder, you need to select pom.xml. I already told it, pom.xml file contain the libraries, whatever library you want to, you need for to develop web application, that libraries we should contain inside a pom.xml file. Okay, you need to select that pom.xml file. Apart from that, it's contain the project name, group name, artifact ID, description, all meta information, project meta information exist in the pom.xml file. Pom.xml file is a heart of configuration file for your Maven tool. Once you select and click OK, it will open this project in the new window. It will ask, do you want to open this project, this window? If you want to open this project, new window. Okay, I will always prefer to go with new window. It's going to importing that project now. When you check your pom.xml file, see whatever I filled in the website, com.id, garden group name, artifact ID, first tab, name is the first tab. Okay, then a description, everything available here. Okay, then I selected web, Spring Boot starter project, a web dependency selected as a web. Okay, so here dependency coming as a Spring Boot starter web. If you include this particular starter project, you can create a web application or you can create a RESTful web service application. Okay, through this, once you added this particular starter project, your Spring Boot application automatically downloads all libraries that needed for your web application. Okay, you don't have to worry about that, automatically pulled by your Spring Boot. When you look at the folder, the base project I have mentioned, com.it garden, inside a first app application. When you open here, there is a small line of code. String application.run first app application.class. See, this class is a starting point of your Spring Boot application. Whenever run the Spring Boot application, it will start from here. Okay. When you see here, there is an annotated in this class, that is at Spring Boot application. I will explain you more about this annotation next class. This Spring Boot this annotation will do all auto configuration for you. You don't have to do anything. Okay, we'll explore more about this annotation in next class. Okay, now I created one simple web application. Simple Spring Boot application. Using this Spring Boot application, I can create a web-based application as well as I can create a RESTful web services. Why? Because I have had a starter project, Spring Boot started them. Okay, how do you start this web application? How do you start this application? Right click, run, that's it. When you right click run, it will start. I think mostly it will not start. I think there is one issue will come. I'm expecting. I will tell you once that issue I see. There is no any bug in our project. Spring Boot by default uses port number 8080, but the port number already used by some other application. I think in currently the some Java based application using the 8080 port number. See, Tomcat initialized with the port number 8080. This is a default port number, but web server failed to start. Port number 8080 was already in use. There is some application already used by this port number. That's the reason it's not able to start. Okay, this will happen commonly for everybody because 8080 is a default port number of your Tomcat server. Since my there is some other Java project running, that Java application uses this port number. That's the reason this application not able to start. So how do we change the port number for this application? You see that there is a resource, right? There is a resource folder. In this resource folder, there is one file called application.properties. Here simply you can say server.port equal to, I want to use 8081. Okay, now you can start. She started first app application successfully started under port number 8081. Okay. Actually, this port issue normally come for everybody. Please make sure that whenever you start your first Spring Boot application, make sure that 8080 is not using any other software. Okay. Then, okay. Now I created a simple Spring Boot application. Now I want to create a one. API endpoint. API endpoint means get, post, delete, like that. One simple API endpoint I want to create. Okay, for that first I'm going to create a one more package dot controller. I have created a new package called com.itgarden.controller. Under this controller package I'm going to create one class app controller, post app controller, post app controller created. Now this particular class should act as a restful control. Okay, for example, I want to create an API endpoint through this Java class. How to enable that? To say at rest controller, if you annotated with a rest controller, this particular class act as a, that is this particular act as a RESTful app services controller. Okay, using this class I can create a several endpoint method. Endpoint means API. Okay, several API I can create through first app controller because I have annotated with at rest controller. How do we create a endpoint method? How do you create a API method? Public string print return, this is my first RESTful web service. Okay, now this print method looks like a normal Java method, right? I am saying this method is a API method. As of now, this method is a normal method. This method is not a API method. This method not a rest control API method. How to make it? For that, there is another annotation called get mapping. Get mapping. Print value. Print data. Okay, I make it as a print. Don't have to give. See, there is no condition. The same name should give here. We can give anything here. Okay. For example, I am making this method as a print data, but I am giving the endpoint is a print. Okay, now get mapping is annotation. Using get mapping annotation, we can create an API endpoint. API endpoint, get API endpoint. Okay. Okay, now we created one simple RESTful web service that will return one string. This is my first RESTful web service. Okay. Now, how do we access this particular method? When in the browser, I want to call, this is running under 8081, right? This particular Spring Boot application running under 8081. How do you refer this computer? In this computer only this application running. Okay, if you want to refer this computer from locally, you need to say localhost colon, then which port? 8081. Like this, you can call this application from the browser, from the client side. If you want to call your RESTful web services from the client side, you need to mention the particular IP of the computer. Since this I'm calling this particular method the same computer where my server is running, so I'm using a localhost. Localhost nothing but I am referring this computer. In this computer, this application running under 8081. So I am mentioning 8081. Okay. Now I want to call this method. How to call this method? Localhost 8081/print. When you say like this, okay. This particular information will get printed in your browser. Now it will not come. White label error page. Okay, now it will not print because I added this method, but I need to restart my server. Okay, once you restarted that, these changes get reflected. When you use this particular URL, it will print. I'll going to restart. Okay, I restarted now. Now going back to browser, same thing I'm going to refreshing. See, this is my first RESTful web services. Okay, successfully we created one simple Spring Boot application. See how easiest in creating a web application in using a Spring Boot. It's a very, very easy. Everything done by Spring Boot itself. All configuration done by Spring Boot itself. See, if you're going to create a same web application using the Spring framework, you have to configure the servlet. You have to configure the dispatcher servlet, a view resolver, and this RESTful web service also we need to configure. Lot of configuration tasks exist in the Spring framework. Okay, in the case of Spring Boot, not like that. Everything taken care by your Spring Boot application. Okay. Okay, in the next video we're going to see how this auto configuration happening. We're going to talk about a Spring Boot application annotation, then we'll talk about the several mappings: get mapping, post mapping, delete mapping, put mapping. There are a lot of mapping annotation is there. We're going to talk about that. Okay, as of now, this class only explains how to create a one simple Spring Boot application. That's it. Okay. If you like this video, please share with your friends and colleagues. Also, who wanted to learn Spring Boot and microservice using Spring Cloud, please share with your friends and colleagues. Until then, bye bye from Suresh Keshan.